Hello and welcome, everyone. I know it's disturbing, but I'm not actually a cowboy. My name is Cyril, CEO and executive producer at Dotemu and the Arcade Crew. My costume has nothing to do with what we're going to talk about today, and that's exactly why I chose it. Live from Paris, the city of lights, and Lille, the city of beers, be prepared for an exclusive sneak peek at the upcoming title from CCCP, The Last Spell. In this video, we'll be presenting the game concept, the team, talking about the current features of the game. Please keep in mind that it is still in alpha state, and that many elements are still missing or incomplete. Today with me are Mathieu and Thomas. Hello guys.
Hey.
Maybe you can introduce yourself, tell us what you do, and what is CCCP?
Yes, of course. So, hi everyone, I'm Mathieu Richer. I'm the creative director and co-founder of CCCP. We are a French small indie dev studio. So, pardon my English. We can hear that I am French. And I have with me Thomas. We will be playing the game during the commentary with a game designer and programmer on the game.
Okay. Yeah, it's a bit weird to talk to each other in French, but in English, sorry, because we're all French. But we didn't have time to get a professional animator, so please excuse our terrible French accent. But yeah, here we go. So yeah, let's get to it. So what is The Last Spell, Mathieu?
So The Last Spell is a tactical RPG with roguelike elements. The pitch of the game is that it's think about a classic fantasy medieval world, like Warhammer fantasy, things like that. But it's all gone to shit. It's kind of there has been big battles between kingdoms in this universe, and the mages launch powerful spells against each other and destroyed nearly everything. So it's kind of a medieval apocalypse. Okay. And so you start the game, you play the last heroes of humanity who want to defend the last bastion of hope of humanity, their last city, okay, still standing, against hordes of monsters that come out at night and want to kill everyone.
All right. Sounds good. maybe we should get to it. Yeah. So this is... it's a demo, right, that we're playing right now? Or is it like a current build of the game?
Yeah, it's the demo of the game, which is available on Steam right now.
Okay.
So you can play freely the game that Thomas is playing right now. So it's quite early alpha stage. It's been 2 years now that we are developing The Last Spell, and there's quite a few months of development still left. But okay. Yeah, you can try to get a grasp of the core mechanics that we wanted to implement.
So yeah, that's important. That's an important element. So this demo is currently available on Steam. So don't hesitate to try it out, guys. It's free, so there is no reason not to. And also don't hesitate to wishlist it, of course, to support us, and to not forget to give us your money when the game is out.
And don't forget, you can come to our Discord to discuss with the team, the dev team, directly. If you have feedback for us after playing the demo, if you like the demo, or if there are things that you didn't like and you want to change, you can discuss directly with us. We are happy to answer questions and to discuss with the community. So yeah, don't hesitate.
So basically right now we are in a kind of city in ruins.
Yes.
And so we have our three heroes. That's yep, actually the number of heroes where you start with, right?
Yeah, for now, so yeah, as we said, it's an alpha stage. So for now we start with three heroes, okay, which are randomly generated. So each game is new. Your heroes have new traits, new characteristics, etc. New portraits, new faces. And so the game is divided into two phases. You have the day phases and the night phase. During the day, you will be constructing buildings, taking care of your heroes, and during the night, you defend against the hordes of monsters who want to kill you and destroy the city. So right now, it's the start of the first night.
First night, okay. So basically, you need to defend the city against the hordes of creatures to protect the mages that are casting the last spell, right?
Yeah.
So if enemies get to those mages and kill them, then the game over and you have to restart with new characters, new characteristics and everything, right?
Yes. It's the goal of the game. It's to protect the center of the city. You talked a bit about the restart and the fact that we restart a lot new games. We want to really have some roguelike elements. For a turn-based strategy game, it's quite unusual. Usually, tactical games like that, it's more some campaign mode, some narrative mode. For us, it's really we really wanted to implement some roguelike elements. So each time you lose a game, you will gain some points that you can spend between games to enhance your experience for the next games, unlock new stuff, get better equipment, things like that. So every time you play and you lose, you really have the sensation that you progress and you unlock new stuff every time.
Okay, and so this is this mechanic, like this meta game mechanic, is not present in this demo, right?
No, for now. We were focused on the core mechanics of the game, and the meta game will come later. But it's really something important for us, so it will take a big place in the game. Yeah.
Can we maybe see a bit more about the characters? Like, so what are their characteristics? How do you like use their skills and stuff like that?
Yeah. So, as I said, the characters are procedurally generated, so they have some basic stats. They have some health, mana, action points and move points, which you'll be using to move and to do actions.
Okay.
And some stats for attack and defense. You have some stats that will enhance their physical or magical damage, make them more critical hits, and a lot of stats for defense. We created a system with four different defense stats. You have block, armor, resistance, and dodge. And some attacks are more efficient against dodgy enemies. Some attacks are more efficient against resistant enemies, etc.
Okay.
So every character has some traits too that will really define their starting characteristics. So we are reworking these right now, but they will really influence the way the character will be played.
Mm-hmm.
And what can I say? Yeah, they start with starting equipment, but of course you will be able to change it over the course of the game.
Okay.
Yeah, maybe you can close that and start playing. And yeah, so the battle. So you play all your characters in the order that you want. There is no initiative in the game. You play all your player character. So the mechanics is that you launch skills with this nice little skill bar at the bottom.
Okay.
So you get skills from the equipment. In fact, there is no class in the game. So at the beginning, every character can be equal, but it's up to you to build some classes of your own. So you can really multi-class your characters as you see fit. So yeah, as I said, the skills come from the equipment you equipped on your characters. Okay. And so yeah, each equipment has different skills, different style of play.
Basically, each character doesn't have a basic class. It just depends on their stats.
Yeah.
The way you see, for example, a character that has lots of mana points and who's very weak will be probably stronger with like mage equipment, like staffs or robes or stuff like that.
Yes.
But you can do anything. You can do like a battle mage or archer, mage, warrior, whatever. Like it's really up to you, right?
Yes, we really wanted to focus on that because in fact you have two sets of weapons, so you can equip two different sets and you can swap them at any time during the battle, and you really can do some hybrid classes, some melee warrior with some range. As you said, maybe you start with a high mana character, but maybe this high mana character will make a strong melee character because melee attacks can use mana too. So,
okay. What we're seeing, right, on the skills. There are the little like numbers above each skills, which indicates the different like conception of each skills, right?
Yes, yes. Okay. In blue, it's mana, and in orange, it's action points, and in green, the move points.
Okay.
So, as you see, the hordes are coming. So, it's another thing in your game. It's that there is really some asymmetry in the forces. You play a few band of warriors, but with great skills against some squishy against hordes of squishy enemies. Mm-hmm. So there is really a sense of asymmetry in the mechanics.
Okay.
And you really have to focus on the number of enemies that you will take down each turn. You really have to optimize the kill count that your heroes will do each turn, because if you don't do that, you will be submerged by the hordes of enemies.
Okay. And you have different types of enemies, right? Because I see only one right now, but there's going to be more.
Yes, for the first night, it's only some basic clawer, we called them. So really dumb, squishy enemies, but coming in large numbers. But every night that passes, you will get new types of enemies with special behaviors. There is a lot of surprises in the coming night to see. So you will have to adapt to the different style of enemies. But maybe we'll show later.
For the next night or something like that.
Yes. So yes, that's something I wanted to say too. So it's a rather hard game. you will lose often, but every new game should be enjoyable because you have new stuff to test and to play with. But we wanted it to be accessible. You can take the game and play it and try to kill a lot of monsters. It's not that hard to smash enemies, larger amount of enemies, but you can have fun rather quickly.
Okay.
But maybe you won't last until the end of the game because you didn't optimize everything perfectly. But yeah, I think everyone will get something from the game. If you want just to squash some enemies and try to get better at the game, you can too.
Okay. Yeah. What I really like when I play the last spell is the fact that you really need to think about the best combinations of equipment, characters, skills, in order to win. And every time it's different, so it's every time it poses a challenge.
Yes.
That you need to really think about, and it's very satisfying when you see that you're combining well, that there are synergies between your different characters, and that you're really like devastating the enemy's army. Yes. So yeah, it's a game about, you know, like thinking about your strategy ahead, and then of course there is like this micro strategy of with the tactical RPG aspects, turn-based aspects, where you have to kind of use your resources in a good way. But that's kind of classic, I'd say. But yeah, the fact that all the characters are really custom and kind of created by yourself and optimized by yourself before each combat makes it really interesting and different from other tacticals, I think.
Yes, that's it. And if you add the two that you have the building aspect too in the game, mm-hmm. so you have this ruined city at the start. When the day will come, you can build some new defenses. You can build some new buildings to help you to build new stuff. And this add a new layer of strategy to the mm-hmm. game. So you not only have to be good during the tactical phases, but you also have to think for the long run, so it's not decisions that will impact you at the start, but maybe in 2, 3, 4 nights you will get some effects of the bad decision that you could have taken at the start. So yeah, I think the game will be rather sandbox for trying strategies. Maybe you want to focus your strategy on building big walls surrounding the city and defending at all costs the walls. Or maybe in another run, you will focus really on the stuff, on the loot of your on the equipment of your characters, and try to get some Superman and try to just defend the ruined city. So yeah, we'll have many paths to try.
Okay. Yeah, you are, because there's not only the characters that came into the game to build up your strategy. There is also all the city aspects that you can manage itself.
Yes.
And the resources management, not only of your characters in terms of mana or move points, but also the resources in general for gold and stuff like that we'll see during the day after once the night is over. Thomas is doing a pretty good job, by the way.
Yeah,
I can see, because so if you guys are watching that, like you say, oh, that looks easy, it's not like really like. So
we really want to see you lose. It's really fun to see streamers try the game and not really be focused on the strategy of the game and really have a hard time finishing the first night, because you have to think a bit about
exactly
what you are doing.
And also it's a demo, so like we're not taking you by the hand. You have to discover some stuff by yourself, which will be the case, I think, in the final game as well. But don't be scared. It's normal to like kind of not doing so good the first night.
Yes,
just,
of course.
Just like try everything out. Try to learn like how all the elements of the game combine on the first nights and days. And then when you start again, it will be much more easier. That was my first experience. And
yeah,
that's actually quite satisfying, because then on your second run, you know what you have to do, right? You're like, okay, this thing, I won't forget about it. And this I will change for sure. And so yeah, that's very cool.
Yes, that's cool. That's what we wanted. We wanted some game that was rather deep, with deep mechanics, but not so scary for new players. But yeah, the thing that okay, I lost my first game, but I want to try new things, and this time I will get better, and you actually get better. It's really satisfying for us as designers.
Nice.
So yeah.
And can you tell us a bit more about the weapon types? Like, what can we expect? Because as they define the classes, what kind of weapons do we have, and what are their like kind of their vantage point and their defaults and stuff like that?
Yes, we have quite a few. We went a bit over our head for the weapons. So basically, it's really a fluid system. There are really few constraints in the system for us as designers. But basically, we have three types of weapons. We have melee-based weapons, so we have swords, axes, hammers, things like that, for two hands or one hand. We have distant weapons, so ranged weapons, like bows, crossbows. We have also rifles and pistols, and we have magical weapons which enables you to launch spells.
Okay.
So
yeah, maybe we'll get into that after, because we'll have to buy weapons, right?
Yes.
In between, I mean, we don't have to, but it's recommended.
Yeah.
So, by the way, GG, Thomas, nice game. I think it's S score, right? So yeah, perfect game. Can you maybe explain a bit, like, what's all this screen and what's Thomas doing?
So each night when you manage to survive, you gain some rewards for securing the city. In fact, you have a system that is the panic level of the city. So each time the monsters attack the city, the people in the city get more panicked and they will give you less rewards after the night. But mm-hmm. here he made a perfect night, so he gets all the rewards. So he can choose one item for free that the people of the city will be giving him. He got some resources, things like that.
So you can compare the object, the weapon you're getting with the ones you have, right? Which is pretty pretty cool.
Yes,
that's a new feature that wasn't there at the beginning, and that's really helpful.
Yeah, we are trying to put some quality of life features like that. With the feedback of the players on our Discord, we wanted to make some addition like that.
Nice.
So right now it's a day phase, so you can do a lot of stuff in this phase. Thankfully, you have the little commander's journal at the left of the screen that will remind you what you can do during this phase, so you won't be lost. So right now is leveling I don't know if you can
leveling up.
Leveling it up.
sorry guys, that's not your fault.
baguette is leveling up his characters, so you have some bonus stat points that you can choose, and you have some perk points. So as we said, it's a class-based system.
What was the leveling up system? So basically you have different like upgrades to choose.
Yes.
Right.
You can choose between 5 upgrades on your basic stats to choose.
Maybe Thomas, you can show us on another character, so we just can get back to that element, which is pretty neat. There you go. Thank you, Thomas. So, okay.
So yeah, you are presented with 5 basic stats that you can improve on your character. They are randomly generated, so you won't get what you wanted, but you can reroll these stats. So for now, when you reroll, you have a bit less choices, but you have more chances to have the stats that will be interesting you. And you can see the effect directly. And some bonuses are more or less high. You can get high bonuses on maybe a stat that won't be interesting you at first, but since the bonus is high, maybe you will take it. So yeah.
Okay. So that's another interesting point, I think, because even if your basic randomly generated character has some stats, with that leveling up system, you can basically change that. And if you really want this character to be a warrior instead of a mage, for example, you can really change completely over different nights and days cycle the way, like, his class, basically, his basic stats. And so it gives really the impression of total freedom of building each character the way you want.
Yeah,
is pretty neat.
Maybe you want to specialize your character, or maybe you want to make it better on their weak points. So you can really try some different things.
Nice.
And the second point of the level up, you have one perk point to use. So you can spend your perk point on the different perks that will really change the way your character will be playing. So these are passive bonuses, but which are quite strong. So you really want to make use of these these passive bonuses during during the strategic battles. And as we said, every character has the same perk perk tree, so you can really build them as you see fit.
Okay. So that was the leveling up, right?
Yeah.
So now, like, all the characters have better skills, better stats, and new perk for each character. And now I see Thomas is looking through the shop, right?
Yeah. You have access you have access to a shop which will regen his stuff every day. So the stuff in the shop is randomly generated, a bit like a Diablo-like style of game. In fact, the equipments they are basic stats, but there are some random passive bonuses on each equipment. So we have some kind of mechanics like in Diablo-like. So you can see the red ones here are epic
weapons.
Epic
right?
weapons. Nice. So maybe too costly for now, but he can buy one epic weapon, but he won't be able to buy anything else for this day. So it's up to you to try and your strategy, and maybe you want to focus on one character, maybe you want to spend your gold on different things. And the passive bonuses on the epic stuff are randomly generated too.
Okay, and I noticed as well that the actual armor that you wear changes your character skin, right? So
you see the pants, torso, and helmet on your character. It's cool.
That's pretty cool.
And of course the weapon. Yes, so he's trying to optimize his characters, maybe
the equipment and like who to give this new weapon that costs a lot of money.
As I said, one tip for new player. As I said, you have two slots of weapons that you can swap freely during the gameplay. So it's really useful to use the two slots, because you really want to have some firepower from range and maybe some firepower from melee distance. So making hybrid characters is really useful in the game. There are some other mechanics that impact that as well. So I think the first goal of the player is to quickly buy a second weapon for every character to have more possibilities during the battles.
Okay. And so basically, Thomas just bought a weapon and then gave it to one of the characters. But the resources that he got from the previous night was gold.
Yes. So you stone have
and weapon, right?
Gold, stone, and weapon. Yeah, which every one of them serves to a purpose. So with gold, you can buy new stuff as he did, and you can buy some new buildings for your city. So you have to choose.
There's the list there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do I focus on on the stuff or on the buildings, or maybe a bit of both, because the buildings are quite useful. So you have some for example, this one will be generating gold each day, so you won't have to rely only on the night rewards, so it can be interesting to do it. So you have some buildings that will be enabling you to heal your characters, to heal their mana, to get some new stuff for free. So you have to strategize too on this part.
What was Thomas doing with the shovel thing a bit earlier?
So it's one of the actions at the start of the game. You can scavenge the ruins of the remnant of the city to get some bonus gold and bonus materials at the start of the game. So it's really a bonus to quick start the game to get some resources. See. But after some time, you won't have access anymore to these resources.
It destroys the buildings, right?
Yeah.
Buildings are destroyed when you do that, so you have less protection. But at the same time, you should build protection with those materials.
In fact, you make room to build the new buildings too, because you have some limited rooms in the city to build the new buildings.
Okay.
At some point, all the city will be won't be any room available. Mm-hmm. So yeah, you want to erase all these useless buildings.
Okay.
At some point, and so the materials, so the little bricks, as we see here, you can use them to build defenses. So for now, we have some walls, which are strong. It can be useful to slow down the enemies because. There will be more and more of them.
Okay.
And we have some special buildings. We have some watchtower. You can put one character on it and it can shoot enemies from afar, so it can be quite useful.
Nice. And I think the tower also like takes out the restriction where like if you're behind a tree, if an enemy is behind a tree, you can't shoot it.
Yeah.
Whereas when you're in the tower, you don't have that restriction, right?
Yes, some weapons have line of sight restrictions, for example, right. the bow. And when you are on the watchtower, you don't have the line of sight.
Nice. So,
but you are immobile. Yeah, very useful, but you are quite immobile. So you have to put the watchtower at the good place because
because basically, we can see now that before the night, you kind of know where the enemy is coming, like on which side, on like which of the four side, north, south, west, and east.
Yes.
But you don't know exactly where. Like, can be like a bit on the left, a bit on the right. So it's always tricky, and that's why you need to place your characters and your buildings in the good spots, right?
Yeah, and it's something that is quite temporary. For now, we give this information from the start to the player. Maybe we'll give the information in a different way for the final game. Maybe you will have some partial informations, and you will have to buy the final information with resources. So we will play with that, something that we didn't say. So for now, they are coming from one side of the city, the enemies. But at some point, they will be coming from different sides.
Yeah.
At the same time, it will be getting more and more.
That's when things get spicy a bit. Like you have only three or four characters, and they're coming from everywhere.
In fact, you will be able to recruit new characters. We don't really know how much we are aiming for 6 or 8 character max.
Nice.
But
that's a lot.
We'll have to see depending on the balancing of the game.
And you can recruit new characters with a building, right?
Yeah. It's a building that is rather costly because one more character is a big firepower for your town. But yeah.
And when you recruit a new character, is he or she already with stuff and levels, or do they start from like zero?
You will be getting. In fact, if you upgrade, that's something that we didn't talk about. But you can also upgrade your buildings in the city. That's new feature we implemented.
But it's not in the demo right now, right? Is it?
It's not in the demo right now.
Okay.
It's some new feature we
have. That will come later, right?
But you will be able to upgrade your buildings and to maybe get a level up heroes when you recruit them with better stuff, etc. But maybe more costly. So yeah, you have to see. One thing interesting, you see a new type of enemy, the Fallen Knight, which is kind of a basic enemy but with a lot of armor, so you have to take down his armor before killing him. Maybe I can talk a bit about the armor system. So it's one of our defensive mechanics. It's quite simple. You have armor gauge, and each turn this gauge replenished to full fully. So it's not really useful to get this gauge to 50% because next turn it will be 100%. So if you want to damage the hit points of the enemy, you really want to focus on it, or to have some weapons that will ignore the armor of the enemy.
I see.
So yeah.
And what about the music? I since the beginning, I don't know if you guys heard, but the intro music is super cool and it changes from day and night. What about it?
Yeah, we are overjoyed because we have Rémi Gallego from the band The Algorithm.
Nice.
Who is making the music for our game. We were pretty fans of him, so we are overjoyed that he accepted to make the music for us. And so yeah, it's a kind of a synthwave metal style, really cool. So yeah, during the day you have this kind of melancholic, moody music, and when the night comes and the action gets on, you really have some punch, some good vibe in the music.
And it's metal time, right?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, I advise that you guys, if you're watching this video, check out on The Algorithm on YouTube. He has several clips, so you can get a taste of what he can do. Of course, he's working on the last spell. It sounds a bit different. It's more adapted to the game itself. But yeah, it surprisingly fits really well. Like the universe, you'd expect some like kind of epic classical music for the game, but this kind of like electronic metal music really fits well and like gives you like pumps up, you know, like when you're playing, you're like, yeah. It feels really nice, actually.
Yeah, we wanted to... It's rather a slow game, it's a turn-based game, so you have to take your time, etc. But we wanted to get some arcade feel in this game, some punch. So we have some really cool animations for the spells, we have this music, we also have a combo system that we didn't implement much for now, but which will be present. So we really want to have some rhythm on, during the battles and some... You have the feeling that you have to defend for your life and things like that. Yeah.
Nice. And I see that sometimes, so there is a mechanic for critical hits as well, right?
Yeah. It's a percentage chance. You have some perks that will be using the critical hits. So it's one of the
mechanics. What about healing? Are there like any class that you can make that are going to be healers, or like is there or a support classes maybe, something like that?
So yeah, in our mind, the game is a bit about survival too. It's the end of the world, so the resources are scarce, and so it's not that easy to heal yourself, to heal your HP and your mana. So you can buy some mana potions, some health potions. You have some ways to recover some health and mana, but it's not as easy and as in classical tactical games. So you won't have some healer class dedicated to healing. So you really have to focus on that and to take care of taking the less hits possible. So maybe taking more armors to be less damage on your HP.
Okay.
You want to use your mana points, because if you don't do it, you will be overwhelmed by the enemies. But at the same time, not spend it needlessly. So yeah, the balance between using your resources and conserving them for later will be important. Yeah.
I see. That's cool. That's really cool. So basically, no healing, no proper healer, to say the least. But you have other mechanics that can compensate that, and some as well weapons and objects that can help you be stronger, basically.
Yeah, of course, and you will have some buff for your characters. You will have some support equipment that will enable you to buff your characters for one turn. You have some armors that give you a skill that enables you to build your armors or your dodge during this turn. So you will be making less damage, but you will be tanking for one turn. So yeah, you have to see how you strategize your turn. Yeah.
Okay. And so, what happens if one of your character dies?
He dies.
Okay, that's it.
Yeah.
Like you won't He's see dead. Him ever again, right? Because it's randomly generated.
Yeah, yeah. We have some ideas to get back some heroes from the dead.
Nice.
but it's a permadeath game. So during your run, it won't be easy to get back your character. Maybe there will be one item that is really costly that will enable you to resuscitate it. But for now, it's not a plan. But maybe in the next runs, your preferred heroes, you will be able to get to recruit them in your next runs. We are not quite sure for now how you will do it, but we want to enable players to get back to heroes that they liked during the course of the game.
And I really like this idea because it reminds me a lot of like classic role-playing games where like you're, you know, leveling up your character with all its equipment, you kind of get attached to it. And because the names are randomly generated as well, so you're like, oh, I like really like this guy, you know, like he's cool looking and he has now the best equipment, he's doing lots of critical, you know,
And when he dies,
and stuff like that. And then he dies and like...
You are suffering You're inside. Like,
no, you know, like, not him or not her, you know, like. That's nice. So yeah, it gives a bit more, in terms of game mechanics, it gives a bit more pressure to kind of not only save your character to save your city, but also just to save him or her because you know it's a very good character that you've been building up, like, in every cycle. And if you just, like, lose him or her, then it's going to be really hard to kind of like be as good as you were when you had him or her.
Yeah, basically. And it's a kind of emotion that we want to the player to experience as designers. It's always fun to that the player get attached to little characters that we created and that he created, in fact, because it's really up to him to or her to create the character that he likes. So yeah. So Thomas is doing a good job, I think.
Yeah, I see that. Like he got barely hit by the second wave, and we're almost there, I think. So yeah, we can see right now the effect of the tower, right? The watchtower, which is pretty powerful.
Yes.
So far, like the range is crazy.
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. Okay, I see.
Yes, one thing I wanted to say too, which is original for our game, for a tactical RPG, it's we really wanted to have a focus on the area of effects skills. Because we are submerged by hordes of enemies, there are literally hundreds of enemies in the game that will be coming at you. And we have a lot of skills that will be taking effect in area of effect, and you have a way to position your heroes and the skills that you will be launching in the more optimized way to get the more damage for the cost of resources. So yeah, for a tactical RPG, it's quite unusual to have a focus on the area of effect skills.
I see, yeah, because there are so many enemies, right? Like you have to have those skills that kill multiple enemies at once, otherwise it's going to be really hard.
You don't want to just kill one monster during your turn. You really want to kill maybe some special monster that will be really taking the focus of the heroes, but yeah, it will be preventing you to focus on the squishy monsters, so yeah, you will have to find the good balance between that.
I see.
So for now, yeah, we only see the Fallen Knight, but after that, in the demo, you can play. There are more types of enemies, so yeah, big area attack here, big damage, cool.
Yeah, with a new weapon, right? The weapon you just acquired on the last round.
The epic spear, yeah. But a bit a good skill, but a bit costly in terms of mana and action points. So
yeah,
you have to use it, but maybe take care.
And if this character dies, the weapon goes with her, right?
Yeah, for now, yes. Okay. But maybe we have some system to get back some equipment. Okay. For now, it's a bit harsh, but yeah, it's kind of alpha stage. So
of course.
Some things like that are subject to changes.
Yeah, of course. Again, for people that are watching this video, don't hesitate to give us your feedback on the game's Discord. It's really helpful, so we can really, you know, it's always hard when you design a game to kind of, you know, get a good feel of what's fair and what's not fair, because, you know, like, everyone has his own opinion. So yeah, CCCP will try their best to have something that's fair for everyone, even if it's going to be a hard game, it's going to be challenging. But so please send us your feedback on the demo. It will be very, very helpful for them to balance the game in the right way.
Yeah, but I think we can adjust some things with options. I really want to have some start options for the runs, and maybe have some things that will help new players to get into the game and to have fun. But keep the hardcore experience to the players we want the hardcore experience.
All right. All right. And so what are your inspirations on The Last Spell? What are the games that kind of, you know, like, that are your references to when you first thought about The Last Spell?
Quite a few.
Yeah.
In fact, I'm a big tactical RPG fan since I was young. I'm getting older and older now. So I think I played nearly all the tactical RPG that came up in all supports possible on PC, on consoles. So yeah, you name it, Final Fantasy, Disgaea, on PC, the XCOM series, or for the big names. But yeah, even the little indie tactical RPG.
That's cool, yeah.
Maybe more recently, there are two indie games that really inspired us. There is Into the Breach, which was so good.
Yeah.
And Battle Brothers, that's like my favorite game.
Okay.
Right now, with nice. With Crusader Kings. But yeah.
Yeah, right.
So yeah, Battle Brothers, small team, but really dedicated gameplay. You play a band of self-sword, and we are really hardcore tactical gameplay, really cool.
If you guys that are watching this video don't know these games, please don't hesitate to go and check them out. They're both on Steam, right?
Yeah, both on Steam.
They're really good games, so same thing here. Like, if The Last Spell, you know, looks like something that you'd like, you'd probably like these other games as well.
Yeah, I'm 100% sure. Okay.
All right, cool. So we're almost done with the last night, right? I mean, the second night at least, and probably the last one of the stream.
Yeah, maybe we.
Only two left. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice job, Thomas. Very nice job. No casualties. No panic. The city's safe. The mages are safe. Okay, that was really cool, guys. I think that's about it. We covered lots of elements in the game, of course. We couldn't cover everything. There's a lot of to discover in the game. You have to experience it, basically. So thank you, Mathieu. Thank you, Thomas, for explaining everything. People, don't forget that this game is actually available. The demo is actually available on Steam right now. So don't hesitate to try it out. It's free. Again, don't forget to wishlist the game if you like it. It's very helpful for us, to really kind of know where we are in terms of, you know, people excitement and stuff like that. It's really helpful, and then it will remind you to buy it when it's out. So it's great, right? So yeah, and also again, don't hesitate to come to our Discord and, you know, like, just to say hi or just to give us some feedback. It's always welcome. It's always interesting. And yeah, so I think that wraps it up. It's a It's very, very good, great looking game, Mathieu. Are you guys looking for a publisher or?
Right, we have a publisher.
That's us, right? Game Cowboy. All right.
Oh, it's a good name for a publisher.
Right.
So Game Cowboy.
Maybe we should change that. All right. Okay. Thank you, everyone. That wraps it up.
Thank you.
And I'll see you guys this weekend. And people, again, go on Steam and check out our Steam page if you like this video. Thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye-bye.